Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the binary encoder. So this binary encoder is the combinational circuit which has n outputs and 2 to the power n or fewer inputs. And its operation is exactly reverse of the decoder. So in case of the decoder, we have n inputs and 2 to the power n or less outputs. And as per the specific input combination, only one of the output is high. But in case of the encoder, exactly reverse happens. Moreover, in the encoder, it has been assumed that at any given time, only one of the input is high. And depending on the which input is high, we get the specific code at the output. So let us take the case of this 4-line to 2-line encoder and let us understand the working of this encoder. So as you can see, this 4-line to 2-line encoder has 4 inputs and 2 outputs. That means here at the output, this n is equal to 2 and the total number of inputs is equal to 2 to the power n, that is equal to 4. And here is the truth table of this 4 to 2 encoder. So as you can see, when the D0 input is high, then the output of the encoder is equal to 0,0. Likewise, when this D1 input is high, then the output of the encoder is equal to 0,1. Similarly, when the D2 is high, then the output will be equal to 1,0. And when D3 is high, then the output of the encoder will be equal to 1,1. So in this way, this binary encoder encodes the input information into the compact code. So now, let us see the logic circuit of this 4-line to 2-line encoder. So as you can see from this truth table, this output A is high when either D2 is high or D3 is high. That means the logical expression of this output A is equal to D2 plus D3. Likewise, this output B will be high when either D1 is high or D3 is high. That means the logical expression of this output B is equal to D1 plus D3. And these two logical expressions can be implemented with the help of the OR gates. So this is the logic circuit of this 4-line to 2-line encoder. Similarly, now let us see the 8-line to 3-line encoder. So in case of this 8 to 3 encoder, it has 8 inputs and 3 outputs. And depending on which particular input is high, we get the specific 3-bit code at the output. So here is the truth table of this 8-line to 3-line encoder. So as you can see, when this D0 input is high, then the corresponding output code is equal to 0,0,0. Likewise, when the D5 input is high, then the output code is equal to 1,0,1. And similarly, when this D7 is high, then the corresponding output code is equal to 1,1,1. So in this way, we get the specific output code corresponding to the individual inputs. And based on this truth table, we can also design the logic circuit of this 8 to 3 encoder. So as you can see, this output A is high when either D4 is high or D5 is high or D6 is high or D7 is high. So we can say that this logical expression of this A is equal to D4 plus D5 plus D6 plus D7. Likewise, this B is high when either D2 or D3 is high or this D6 or D7 is high. That means the logical expression of this B is equal to D2 plus D3 plus D6 plus D7. Similarly, the C output is high when either D1 is high or D3 is high or D5 is high or D7 is high. So we can say that the logical expression of this C is equal to D1 plus D3 plus D5 plus D7. So in this way, we got the three logical expressions for the output A, B and C. And these three expressions can be implemented with the help of the OR gates. So this is the logic circuit of this 8-line to 3-line encoder. So as you can see, this binary encoder encodes the input information into the compact code. So in this way, the encoder is particularly useful when we want to connect the so many input devices to the processor or the controller. For example, let's say we want to connect the 8 switches to the controller. And let's say this each key represents the specific symbol or the specific action. For example, let's say we are designing the gaming pad for some application. That means whenever this key is pressed, then the input to the particular pin is equal to VCC. And in that case, we will get the high input at the particular pin. And when the switch is not pressed, then the input to that pin is equal to 0. So in this way, the processor or the controller can know that the particular key is pressed. So without the encoder, in this case, we require the 8 such input-output pins of the controller. Of course, nowadays, the controller comes with so many I/O pins. But when you want to connect so many inputs to the controller, then you might run out of the number of I/O pins. So in such case, the encoder is very useful. So in such case, what we can do? We can connect the 8 switches to the encoder, and the output of the encoder can be given to the controller. So depending on which key is pressed, we get the specific code at the output of the encoder. And by reading that code, the controller can know that which key is pressed. So in this case, instead of the 8 pins, we just require the 3 pins. And in this way, we can save the number of I/O pins. So that is one of the use of this binary encoder. So this 8-line to 3-line encoder, which you have discussed, can also be used for octal to binary conversion. So in such case, the each input represents the specific octal number, and the output of the encoder is the binary code, which is equivalent to the particular octal digit. So likewise, we can also design the decimal to BCD encoder. So in this decimal to BCD encoder, we have 10 inputs and 4 outputs. So here, the each input represents a specific decimal digit, and the output is the BCD equivalent code corresponding to the particular digit. So here is the truth table of this decimal to BCD encoder. So as you can see, corresponding to the particular input, we get the 4-digit BCD code. That means whenever this D0 input is high, then the corresponding BCD code is equal to 0000. Likewise, when this D7 input is high, then the corresponding BCD code is equal to 0111. And similarly, when this D9 input is high, then the corresponding BCD code is equal to 1001. So with the help of the truth table, we can also design the logic circuit of this encoder. For example, this output A is high when either D8 is high or D9 is high. That means the logical expression of this A is equal to D8 plus D9. Likewise, this B output is high when this D4 is high or D5 is high or D6 is high or D7 is high. That means the logical expression of the B is equal to D4 plus D5 plus D6 plus D7. Similarly, the output C is high when either D2 is high or D3 is high. Likewise, this output C is also high when this D6 is high or D7 is high. So we can say that this logical expression of the C is equal to D2 plus D3 plus D6 plus D7. Likewise, the logical expression of the D is equal to D1 plus D3 plus D5 plus D7 plus D9. So this is the logical expression of the D. So in this way, we got the 4 different expressions for the individual outputs. And each of them can be implemented with the help of the OR gates. So here is the overall logic circuit of this decimal to BCD encoder. And in this way, we can implement the particular encoder. So now, let us see few limitations of this normal encoder. So in case of the normal encoder, we have assumed that at the most, only one input is high. But when all the inputs of the encoder are 0, or when more than one inputs are high, then this encoder circuit will not work properly. And to understand that, let us take the case of this 8-line to 3-line encoder. So in case of this 8 to 3 encoder, when this D0 input is high, then the corresponding output is equal to 000. And that is also evident from the logic circuit. Because here, this D0 input is not connected to any of the OR gate. That means whenever this D0 input is high and all other inputs are 0, then the output of the 3 OR gates will be equal to 000. But suppose if all the inputs are 0, then also the output of this encoder will be equal to 000. That means for the two different input conditions, we will get the same output. So to resolve this discrepancy, we can have one more output to this encoder, which will indicate that at least one of the input to the encoder is high. So if all the inputs to the encoder are 0, in that case, this output V will be also be equal to 0. And when this V is equal to 0, in that case, it doesn't matter what is the other outputs of this encoder. So in this way, we can distinguish the condition when all the inputs to the encoder are 0. Apart from that, the other issue with this encoder is that if more than one inputs are high, then the output of the encoder will be invalid. For example, if this D1 input is high, then the output of this third OR gate will become high. And if rest of the inputs to the encoder are 0, in that case, the output of this OR gates should be equal to 001. Similarly, when this D2 input is high, then the output of the second OR gate will become high. And if the remaining inputs are 0, then in that case, the output of this encoder will be equal to 010. But suppose, if both inputs D1 and D2 are high simultaneously, in that case, the output of the second and the third OR gate will become high. And if we see the overall output of this encoder, then that is equal to 011. And this output indicates that the input D3 is high. But actually in this case, the input D1 and D2 are high. And in this condition, we are getting the invalid result. That means this normal encoder will not work when more than one input to the encoder are high. And to avoid that, we need to set the priority to the inputs. For example, we can set the priority like when more than one inputs are high, then the input with the higher subscript will have the more priority. And in that case, that input will be considered as high. So such encoders are known as the priority encoder. So let's say in this priority encoder, the input with the higher subscript has the higher priority. So now, suppose this D1 and D2 inputs are high simultaneously, in that case, this D2 will have the more priority. And in that case, the output of the encoder will be equal to 010. On the other end, if this D2 and D5 are high simultaneously, in that case, this D5 will have more priority. And in that case, the output of the encoder will be equal to 101. So in this way, in case of the priority encoder, even if more than one inputs are high, then based on the priority, we will get the specific code at the output. So apart from that, to sense the all input condition, we can also have one more output to this priority encoder. That means when all the inputs are 0, then this output V will also be equal to 0. And when one or more than one inputs are high, then this output V will be equal to high. So in this way, with the help of the priority encoder, we can eliminate the two limitations of this normal encoder. So that is the brief introduction of this priority encoder. So in the next video, we will learn about this priority encoder in detail. And we will also see the logic circuit of this priority encoder. Apart from that, we will also learn how to design the large priority encoder using the small priority encoder. But I hope in this video, you understood about this normal binary encoder. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.